I have been very, very impressed with the New York Islanders. They have been so impressive. Not only the goaltending, Varlamov has been as good as we couldn't expect. I thought they brought Varlamov in to help with Sorokin because everybody thought Sorokin was going to come over from Russia after this year because his contract is up with the KHL, and he did sign with the Islanders, but because of the rules, the NHL rules, that if you're playing overseas and before the trade deadline and you're not brought to the team, you're not signed by the team before the trade deadline, if you make the playoffs, you cannot play in the playoffs. So Sorokin is not playing in the playoffs. But Varlamov has been as good as anybody could expect. I've been very, very impressed. Back-to-back shutouts for Varlamov. The last Islander goaltender to do that in the playoffs is Billy Smith, was the last goaltender to do that. And you're talking about in the 80s. So it's been over 40 years, 30 years, 35 years since we've seen an Islander goalie have back-to-back shutouts in a playoff series, the semifinals.
No one's done it. Smith just has a record for most consecutive scoreless minutes.
Yeah, well, that's two games.
No, but one of them was overtime, so it's not figured that way. But Varlamov was the first, just even more impressive, Varlamov was the first goaltender to ever do it.
Mm.
Well, he's been outstanding.
Well, he's been very he's been outstanding, and the New York Islanders' defense has been outstanding as well. When you look at Pelech right now, mm-hmm. ever since Pelech has come back. Now, if you remember, before the trade deadline, Pelech got hurt. He ripped his Achilles. So a lot of people thought his season was over, but because of COVID-19, he's had a little bit of time. I don't think he teared his Achilles because then he wouldn't be playing this season. But I think he teared a little piece, or he pulled it, or whatever the heck he did. Pelech is now back, and you see the difference of what this defense could be with Pelech going on the first line defense with Pulak. And right now, what you see what the Islanders are doing right now is they're completely shutting down top offensive teams. Last night against Philadelphia, who has been explosive throughout the playoffs that we've seen so far. Philadelphia won the number one seed. It was a surprise that Philadelphia Flyers won the number one seed, but it's no surprise that they're in the semifinals of what they've done offensively and defensively in goaltending. But their goaltender did not have one of his top games yesterday, especially in the third period when the Islanders went crazy against him, scored two goals against him, and then had an empty net goal, which practically seized the deal closed the deal for the Philadelphia Flyers in the first game of the semifinals. But what I am so surprised about is the Islanders' goal scoring. It has been very impressive. When you go, you're watching what Barzal could be, even with this offense, and really they depend a lot on the forwards to play defense. So you're not going to see, unless you have a high-powered Ovechkin or somebody of that magnitude, you're not going to see a guy that's going to score 40 goals in this kind of defense, in this kind of offense. It's just not a Barry Trotz type of game. But what you have seen right now in Barzal, Bolivier, what you've seen so far, even in Brock Nelson, and what they've done on all their lines, even their fourth line, the way they're playing and the forechecking the Islanders are playing at the top level, the Islanders have been the best defensive team in the playoffs. You see why I tell everybody, and I this is no lies to all the Ranger fans. If you don't have defense, you're not going to win championships. I don't know why everybody thinks I'm crazy. And Mikey C, who thinks he knows everything about hockey, and I'm taking a shot at Mikey C, because Mikey C told me straight up that the Rangers have more talent than the Islanders. And I said, how do you figure they have more talent when the Islanders are the better team? Well, team hockey is different from talent. No, it's not. You need talent to be a good team. So when you look at their defense, the Rangers don't have defensive players of that magnitude what the Islanders have. They just don't. They don't have a Pelech. They don't have a Pulak. They don't have anybody. When you're depending on a rookie in Adam Fox, to do everything defensively, and then you have all old-timers running around and skating around on the ice with their tail between their legs, that's not defense.
Yes, Mark Stahl, we're looking at you.
I'm talking about where the Rangers are at right now, and all we hear about is who they're going to re-sign. Are they going to re-sign D'Angelo? Are they going to do this? Are they going to do that? And really what the Rangers should be doing is thinking about what they're going to do with that first pick. Should they make that pick, or do they trade down and get a top defenseman and maybe get the best defenseman in a draft? That would make more sense for the Rangers in the future, but knowing the Rangers in that organization, they're not going to do that. They're going to go with the Lafreniere guy. What's his name?
Alexis Lafreniere.
Lafreniere, and they're going to go with him. And I think they're going to make a big mistake. I don't care how good Alexis Lafreniere is offensively. The problem is it's not the offense that the Rangers have problems with. Even in the playoffs, they don't score goals. Even their top guys, Panarin, Zibanejad, they just couldn't put the puck
in the
net.
That's always been a problem. Even when they had the defense, they didn't have the offense. Now they have the offense without the defense.
You look at the Islanders right now, and I'm not taking a shot at the Ranger fans, even though I really want to. I'm not taking shots at the Ranger fans. I'm not taking shots at the Rangers organization. But when you have guys, a.k.a. Mike the Beave, calling up the show and telling me that the Rangers have a better chance of winning a championship in the next 5 years than the Islanders, I don't know what he's smoking, but the Islanders have an opportunity this year to win a Stanley Cup. So this is, and I'll tell you this right now. If the Islanders get into the Stanley Cup Finals, I'm going to be very upset because I could have went to the Stanley Cup playoffs. I could have. I was invited to be over there for our network, and I decided not to go because of COVID-19. And, of course, the year that I decide not to go, the Islanders are going to make a run all the way to the Stanley Cup and possibly win it with this team. And Barry Trotz, if somehow the Islanders get to the Stanley Cup Finals, not only is Barry Trotz one of the great coaches we've seen in a very long time, he could go down as one of the greatest Islander coaches of all time, right behind Al Arbor, who has won 4 Stanley Cups with the New York Islanders organization.
Well, he's already very close. If not, he's in the top 5 of all-time wins, Barry Trotz. So that ends up helping that case as a whole. It was mainly for a while. He just needed the cup. Now he had the cup with the Capitals and has a chance to do it with a probably lesser talented team than what he had with the Capitals.
I wouldn't say lesser.
Than what he had with the Capitals?
I think the Capitals had a better offensive team, but I think defensively, I think this is a better all-around defensive team. The Islanders have a better all-around defensive team. Now, goaltending, no. At the time, Holpe was one of the great goaltenders in the NHL. But Varlamov is playing as good as any goaltender in the playoffs. Go look at his numbers. Go match out all the numbers of the goaltenders right now in the playoffs. Besides Lerner, who is an ex-Islander, he has outplayed every single goaltender in the playoffs. So, to me, as much as you took shots, and I took shots of Varlamov when I watched him play against the Rangers at Nassau Coliseum right against the glass, and I thought Varlamov sucked, maybe the time off really helped Varlamov, giving him a little bit of a breather, a little bit more confidence, and I guess he figured something out because Varlamov is playing at the top of his game. We have never seen Varlamov play at the top of his game, even though I would say about 4 or 5 years ago, he's one of the top 5, top 6 goaltenders in the NHL.
But he was bad in the playoffs then, too. So he turned that thing around as well. Remember Colorado, his first year when they broke out, they won the division. And then Varlamov struggled in that series. They lost to Minnesota. And then I think the year after, they were a lower seed, and he was really bad.
It's been very impressive. It really has. And the New York Islanders deserve a lot of credit because when you look at the team and you look at all the talent in this playoff still, you look at Philadelphia, who's more talent all around, the Philadelphia Flyers or the New York Islanders? I would say the Philadelphia Flyers. When you look at the teams like Boston, who's more talented, Boston or the Islanders? You would say Boston.
Tampa, definitely.
And Tampa, too. All the teams right now in the playoffs are more talented than the Islanders, but the Islanders are a team. They play team hockey. And when you play team hockey, no matter how much talent you have, if you can get into the dance, you can go far into the playoffs. And if a team makes a mistake or a team falls into this scoring drought, the Islanders could win. And you see what they did against Philadelphia. They shut down the Philadelphia Flyers. The Philadelphia Flyers were doing the shutouts. They were doing the shutouts the last round. Their goaltender had back-to-back shutouts in the first round of the playoffs. And you saw what he was doing. Now all of a sudden they bump into the Islanders, a hot Islander team that, let's be honest, it was the smartest thing in the world that the Islanders didn't sweep. They did not sweep in the first round. Because to me, what we saw with the Hurricanes last year after sweeping the Pittsburgh Penguins, the Islanders completely got dominated. And I wanted to see the Islanders figure things out. And I think Barry Trotz has figured things out with this team. I think he understands what they need to do, how they need a forecheck against this team. This isn't the Capitals now. This is the Philadelphia Flyers. And I thought the Islanders matched up better against this team than the Boston Bruins or the Tampa Bay Lightning. And They're going to have to play one of the other teams going into the next round if the Islanders get through with Philadelphia. But I think with the confidence level, the way they're playing, Anders Lee is putting the puck in the net, which is a good sign. Barzell's making these crazy passes. Bolivier, and how about Pageau? I mean, Pageau has been phenomenal since the Islanders made that move, make that trade. They give up their first-round draft pick this year and their third-round draft pick to get Pageau. And Pageau has not – he's impressed. He hasn't really – done anything wrong since he's come to the Islanders. He has 5 goals right now. He's got over 12 points right now in the playoffs, and he has an opportunity right now, being that he's one of the best face-off men in the NHL, to lead this team to a possible Eastern Conference Championship, where we haven't seen the Islanders play in an Eastern Conference Championship in over 30 years. It's remarkable. It is absolutely remarkable. If somehow Barry Trotz and his team gets into the Eastern Conference Finals, being that nobody would have thought that the Islanders would be here in the semifinals, 1-0, 4-0 in the first game. Mark, you're an Islander fan. What are your thoughts to what the Islanders are doing right now? Are you surprised the way Barry Trotz's team is playing?
I'm not surprised because of the way they played to start the season, so I thought they would pretty much pick up on that same thing with having all this time off. They usually play better when they come out like that because they've been rested and they had Pelech back. And I think a lot of that was why they've been successful at first. But the big difference with why they're dominating teams is because they're outplaying them 5-on-5. They're not even close. I mean, they've only allowed 6 goals. They've scored 21. Their plus 15 goal differential is the best among the NHL teams in the playoffs. Mm-hmm. And the only one even close to them is Vegas at plus 11. So 5-on-5, they've dominated. Only 2-for-23 on the power play since the Capitals series.
They're not a good power play team.
No, they've never been. But the system, like you said, is designed to put a lot of pressure on the other team and to make them make mistakes and to frustrate them. The Islanders always block a lot of shots. They always get a lot of hits, and they just torture teams. And I think that's really worked well for it, like it did earlier in the season when they had a 17-game unbeaten streak. It's working well now. So any matchup problems they might have isn't as bad. Plus, the Islanders have 4 really good lines, and that's really strengthened since Pageau and Brassard and Johnston on the third line, because you know they got a great fourth line. And the second line, too, with Bailey's had a great postseason. Bavillier's had a great postseason. Guys that they've needed to step up have. And
they got a lot of leaders on this team. Mm-hmm. And that's the difference right now. The leadership of this team, bringing Pageau and bringing out the defenseman from the Devils. Who was that guy?
Andy Green.
Green, who's been impressive too. A leader. He was the captain of the Devils before he got traded to the Islanders. A lot of Islander fans were wondering why they brought Green, especially with Dobson and all the young players that they have right now, Bodie Wild right now in the farm system. Mm-hmm. Why would they bring Green? Now you're seeing it in the playoffs, the background that he has, getting into the playoffs with the Devils. He's been in the Eastern Conference Championship with the Devils. He was also in the Stanley Cup Finals with the Devils. He understands what it takes to win. And Barry Trotz likes these old defensemen. You saw what he's doing. You see what he's doing. He's got 3 veteran defensemen on this team and a bunch of young guys trying to figure things out. Pelech and Pulik, they're all young. Pelech is 25, 26. Pulik is 25, 26. This is a young defense, and they're starting to figure out who they are, their identity. And I just, to me, it's just so impressive. So you know who's also been very impressive? The Dallas Stars have been very impressive.
Did Patrick text you again?
Yes, he did. And he's been very impressed with the Islanders. By the way, he texted me yesterday telling me, wow, the Islanders look really, really good. And I said, they look better than the Dallas Stars. He says, I don't know about that. They're in the Western Conference.
If they play in the Stanley Cup, this is going to be interesting in terms of your texting.
Could you imagine that? The Dallas Stars versus the New York Islanders in the Stanley Cup Finals.
Rematch at 81. Yeah. I mean, 5 straight games they won.
Yeah, I'm very interested to see what these two. 2 Cinderella teams that shouldn't be here. Dallas should not walk past Calgary. They're right now up 1-0 against Colorado.
2-0. They won yesterday.
2-0. I'm sorry. 2-0. They won yesterday. I'm sorry. 2-0. And Dallas has a chance now to get to the Western Conference Finals, and anything could happen. You know, with the NHL, anything could happen. And I told you about Colorado. As good as Colorado is on paper, the speed that they have, they're a young team. And their defense is still skeptical. I just don't trust their defense, their young defense, in games like this. Dallas is a veteran team. They are. With Ben and the players that they have. This is still a veteran team that has done this before. They haven't gone far into the playoffs with this team and this roster. Right. But the coaching has been phenomenal. Their goaltending has been phenomenal.
Pavelski.
Yep.
Pavelski's got as many goals as Ben Kidd.
Oh, Pavelski's a sensational. Oh, that's a Hall of Famer. Pavelski is a Hall of Famer.